Tell me a little bit about Powder. Tell me a little bit about this horse. How old is she? How you got her and everything else? Just the Cliff's Notes version. How old is she?
Best guess, she's between 9 and 11.
All right.
She's confiscated by the Sheriff's Department. She's rescued. Had her about a year, year and a half. I have ridden her. Doesn't have any real issues that I know of. Hadn't been worked with.
Yeah, she doesn't have any respect, and she runs from you, won't be caught. I tell you what, why don't you take up a position on the other side of that tarp there, block off that kind of hole, so in case she does try to go through it. Okay, Powder, 9 to 11 years old, Sheriff's Rescue. I'm taking my glasses off. I didn't do a proper introduction here. We just chased her into this pen. Now, this is a join-up using a cattle sorting pen. It's all we've got. This is to prove that you can do a join up in something other than a round pen. You got to work for it though. You got to keep the horse out of the corners, and that's what we're going to try to do with Powder here. She's keeping an eye on things, and you'll notice that there's grass here. She's going to put her head down if she gets distracted. My job is to keep her attention and her focus on me. So I've got good eye contact now, and I'm going to send her off and see what happens. Let's go, Powder. Yeah. Using this, I don't, no, just stand there, don't work her, just stand there, just be an obstacle. I want her focused on me. She tried to change direction in that corner, she's just going to try to change it again. I want to keep her going in the direction that I want her in, and I'll let her change when I want her to change. She's getting in the corner. When they stop down in the corners like this, there, now she cut that corner off pretty good. All right, she's looking at me. She's trying to figure out what I want. Yeah. Eye contact, using the lunge whip only as an extension of my arm, trying to keep her adrenaline up. She's looking to see how to get out of the pen. Now she's in the corner. Didn't let her stop down. I'm trying to stay a beam, her girth line in between her shoulder and her hip. That way she can't outrun me. I'm always in her eye. Looking predatory, keeping my shoulders square. My shoulders are parallel to her top line. I want that inside ear locked on me. She's still looking for an escape route. That's why the ear's going around and around. She's looking everywhere she can, try to get to these other horses. All right, there she goes. In the corner trying to hide, doesn't work. Keep her going. I'm not having to get too crazy here. We may get a natural circling instinct here in a little bit. She'll cut that corner out completely. She's looking in, she's tilting her nose in. She's looking at me to see if I'm going to give her any submission signs where she doesn't have to work anymore. See the circles getting smaller here? That's her herd instinct kicking in. She's gone completely from trying to hide in the corners to circling closer and closer, testing to see if I'm still mad at her. She wants to come in, but she's got a long way to go before we get to that point. We need a head lowering, and we need some licking and chewing. She's down to a trot now. The adrenaline's wore off. The flight instinct has been replaced. There, look at the head bob. She's irritated by this. She doesn't like to have to work. I don't blame her. It's in the 90s today. That doesn't necessarily mean she'll be more cooperative because she's getting hot. Speaking about hot, this might be a good time to point out that horses can sweat. Wolves and mountain lions cannot. And that's how a horse has developed its flight mechanism, where it can outrun or outlast a predator, because the predators are sprinters. The only way that they can reduce their body heat is to stop and pant, get that body heat out of their bodies through their mouths. The horse, like a human, can sweat it out. They eliminate heat through perspiration. Here we go, keep her going. Doesn't look like she's ever seen this before. She doesn't know what it's about. I'm trying to peel back those onion skins of domesticity where she may have been lunged repeatedly and thinks that this is just an exercise. But I've got solid eye contact with her. I've been watching her eyes continuously since we started. And that's predatory on my part. That's what a predator does. Lock eyes on when they're in pursuit. And that's how to keep her interest and keep her adrenaline up. Now when she realizes that I'm not a predator, that I'm not going to catch her, kill her, and eat her, then she starts to peel back those onion skins to the herd instinct, because this is how the horses are kept in line in their own herd for improper or dangerous behavior to the rest of the herd. They're sent away, and I'm sending her away. But there's a big change in her from earlier on when we first started. She's not panicky and running into the corners now. I've got the ear on me. I'm going to step her up and see if I can get a little more adrenaline out of her. I've widened out the circle a little bit, let her know that I'm still not happy with her. I want to see the head lowering. I want to see some licking and chewing. There's a head lower. She lowered it just a little bit. Now I'm going to change directions. We should get some good adrenaline from this side. She may even try to go back into the corners. There she goes. See, she was very comfortable going counterclockwise and making those circles smaller. As soon as I went to the opposite side, whoa, I've never seen this before, and she's trying to run in the corners and hide again. Left brain, right brain. This side of the horse did not see what the other side of the horse saw initially and learned that there wasn't any real threat there. This should be a very good example of why you have to train both sides of the horse equally. You have to get them going in both directions. There she goes back in that corner again. I'll keep her going clockwise until she starts to do those little circles around me. There she tried to cut a corner. Come on, get, get, get. That's it, that's it. When the adrenaline starts to come down, like it did on the left side, there it is. She didn't go into the corner that time. Good girl. My eye on her eye. That inside ear is locked on me. Circle's getting smaller again. So we're almost at a balance point where we were going counterclockwise. She's seen it from both sides now. Again, oh, that was a good look. She wanted to come in. Now, it's too hot. Yeah, that corner. Get out of that corner. I can't let her get into a corner and stay there for more than 3 to 5 seconds. If I do, she'll lose interest in what we're doing, and it's like starting all over again. Horses are very distractible, and they will actually forget what it was they were doing and why they were doing it. So I've got to keep her engaged. Good close circle. Now, as I mentioned in my book, you got to set yourself up for success and not failure. We just happen to be doing this in 90 plus degree heat, which is tough on me and it's tough on the horse. Now, when I fully intend to go for a good join up, I don't want to put that much physiological stress on the horse, and certainly not on myself. We're not out here to have a heat stroke. We're out here to work on our respect issues. So I can go for a marginal join up, which means marginal means I don't get the licking and chewing, but I've certainly invested a lot of time in this horse, getting her to move her feet to yield her space to me, and that's very dominant in her language. I don't want her to be afraid of me. I want her to know that coming into me is a comfortable place to be and a safe place to be, but I also don't want her or me to get heat stroke, so I may stop this a little early before we get the head lowering and the licking and chewing. I'm going to go back to her other side. I'm going to make her change direction. It's my idea to change direction, not hers. Here we go. Back to the original side. Doesn't go to the corners because she's seen this before from this side. So it's something she's familiar with. That inside ear is staying locked on me. She's given up pretty much on trying to find a way out of here. So she's dealing with me, which is what we want. There's licking and chewing. Very little bit of it. But in this heat, I'm going to go passive and walk away from her and see what happens. Nothing, I don't feel anything. So I'm going to come into her. Solid eye contact. She looks at me. Try to draw her in. That didn't work. Try it again. She's got herself up against the fence here. There's no place for her to go. She's turning her head away. Okay, that didn't work. So she doesn't make any attempt to join up. So we send her around again. Let her know that that was not acceptable. I want her to at least turn and face me. And when they won't do that, what I did by going in on her, pushing my eye pressure onto hers, wanted to make her turn away. Get. Which was a submissive move on her part. Now she's back in that corner. She just wants to get away from this. There we go. There we go. It's all right. Here we go. And I'm going to stop her down in a place where she's not so confined. I'm just taking the eye pressure off. As soon as I stop pushing, she quits. Now she's standing with her back to me. I don't like that. There's the look. You're right in the camera, kid. Yeah, come on. There, she turned. It's okay. Okay, that's the right thing to do. That's the right thing. Come on. Here we come. That's a step or two. I'm going to try again. I'm going to roll my shoulder by her. I'm off in this corner where the camera can't see me. That's wonderful. Here we go. Licking and chewing. I can hear it. Good girl. Oh, easy now. Easy now. Easy now. Easy now. You did the right thing. Good girl. Good girl. No eye contact. Give her a good rub. She's head shy. It's all right. It's all right. Come on, walk with me. Come on, walk with me. Walk on. All right, we'll try it this way. Walk on. Come on. All right, that was absolute minimal. I'm going to try to bring her in again. Yeah. Yeah. Look at the eyeball goobers you got. Come on. Come on. Yeah, well, she's facing me. That's good. Good girl. It's all right. It's all right. Come on. Come on. Now she's distracted. She's down eating the dirt. All right, I'm going to leave it at that because it's so hot. I did get her trust. She's still pretty leery. This is the one you sized? Okay. Yeah. Let's see if I've got enough trust to get the halter on her. Yeah. I'm not looking directly at her. I'm just coming up to her. Let me pet you, honey. That's a girl. Good girl. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right. All right. We're going to have a problem then. You're going to have to go back to work. You're going to have to go back to work. Yeah. Yeah. Get out of the corner. Get out of the corner. Go on. Get. Make the right thing easy and the wrong thing difficult. Now, I'm not just lunging her as a reprimand. I'm also trying to convince her that coming in here and standing by me is a lot easier than turning her back to me and walking away. Ah, get. Push a little bit more adrenaline through her. I'm going to stop her down. Nope, she went into the corner. I don't want that. Get out of the corner. Get out of the corner. Get out of the corner. Go on. That's it. Okay. All right, let me stop for a second. She's on autopilot. She's going back in that corner. Nope, didn't change direction. Doesn't make any difference. She's already figured out she can't get out of here. That horse isn't helping her. When you first start out, yeah, but the distraction is okay. You need some distraction. It's better to start out when you're first doing it with a horse. That's join up, I mean. It's better to do it where they cannot see the other horses. It takes a little bit more time to do it because you've got to push them past that point of trying to get to the other horses for safety. They have to realize that coming to you is the safety zone. But once you push them past that, when they stop hiding in the corners, when you get that inside ear locked on you, they have already gone past the point of being worried about the other horses. But to answer your question, yes, it's better to do it when the other horses aren't in close proximity and can't come over to visit. So you basically have to put the horses up. Okay? I'm going to take the pressure off. She's going to run right past into that corner. No, maybe not. Good girl. She saw me pick up the halter. All right. We'll use that then. We'll use the halter to drive her. All right, I'm going passive. All right, she's looking. Now, this is the different side of a horse. I didn't try to join up with her on this side before. There we go. That's all right, she's looking at me. That's good. All right, Powder. Hey, kid. Hey, come on, come on. All right, we're on the edge of a, what I call a marginal join up here. You got, oh, she got mucus in her eyes. I'm guessing her allergies. Okay, I'm not looking at her eyes. I'm taking the pressure away. It's all right. It's all right. I'm just going to give her a rub. It's all right. Yeah, I know it's hot here. It's hot here, huh? Yeah, I know it is. I'm here. I'm here. It's all right. It's all right. All right, good girl. Easy. Easy. Good She's got a cut on her nose. So I'm hooking this up loose. Yeah, that abscess. I got to be careful with this because the abscess is right underneath the halter. There, well, look at this. We're getting licking and chewing. She's thinking that that's not too bad. Now, this is a marginal hookup. This is ending the exercise on a good note. Her adrenaline's gone. She's not resisting being haltered or held. I took all the pressure off, the mental pressure. No eye contact. I'm just giving her a rub. Oh, honey, is that a tick? What she got on your ear? Yeah, I know it hurts, doesn't it? You want to check that ear when you get a hold of her, Justin. I don't know, I can't, without my glasses up close, I can't tell whether that's a tick or just a booger. Stay back there. I'm still working with her. Yeah. She's letting me touch her in all her vulnerable places. I don't want her to walk away from me. She probably will because this is a minimal joint up. But I'm going to ask for her feet. See how we do. Good girl. All right. Now she's probably used to giving her feet. We don't know a whole lot about her, and I know the farrier's been out here before. But this is something you still go through with a horse after you've done a join up to confirm that you've got some trust from the horse where it will give you its feet. Because a horse has to have some trust in you to give up its feet. That's its main flight mechanism. All right, let's see how she leads. Walk on. Okay. Good girl. Bring her around. Now, if this were a true solid hookup, I wouldn't be holding her halter. I'd be asking her to follow me on her own free will. She's not at that point yet. She'll need to have several more join-ups and hookups to fully understand and get in touch with her basic instincts that she has as a horse and develop trust along the way, as long as the reward is there. And the reward is I removed all the pressure. She's still pushing in. That's better. She's crowding a little bit.
Why does she crowd like that? I've noticed that when I have let her on the
road. Number of different reasons. Primarily, she's not very respectful. She's still trying to say, hey, you know, I don't have to give up my space to you. You're going to have to prove it, that you deserve it, and that you earn it. You got to earn my respect. But she has to also know where her space is, what's permissible and what's not. And that's not the subject of today's lesson. Today's lesson was a subject of seeing how and if she would join up. She needs some work on that. But this is a good example of what you have to do to get a minimal join up. You can't be pushing for one of those textbook join ups all the time and expect to get them. And if you don't know what to do, if you're not getting it, if it's going too long, it's too hot, you got to stop somewhere. So you find a point like this where there's no adrenaline, she's not upset, she wasn't crazy about being haltered, don't blame her, that's not bothering her abscess all that much. I'm going to let her go and I'm just going to walk away from her. Take all the pressure off. She can do what she wants. And she'll probably look around, put her head down, and try to nibble on some grass. All right, let me see if she'll let me walk back up to her and catch her. Good girl. No eye contact, head's lowered, that's a good sign, that's submission. Head's not up in the air. She is a little head shy. Don't know the reason for it, doesn't make any difference what the reason is. We just got to get her past it and get her confidence back. Good girl. Good girl. Alright. Let me see if she gets a little crazy on this lunge whip. I'm going to move it. Yeah, she's not sure about it. She thinks I'm going to start working her again. And put it away. And here's her lead rope. A lot of horses will run when they see the lead rope or a halter because they think they associate it with work. It's no big deal. I'm not making any eye contact. Yeah, she sees the lead rope. It's okay, sweetie. No big deal. Not sneaking up on her. Just walk right up to her. Shake her by the halter. I didn't expect her to spook. I was ready if she did. I just hook her up and walk away with her. Now, granted, it's a lot easier to do this in a little cattle pen like this than a 5-acre paddock. She didn't have a whole lot of places to go. But it's a start, so you work in this kind of environment until she realizes, no big deal. No big deal. Huh. That's a good girl. Yeah. Good girl. Take it off of her and walk away. I didn't make her work. It didn't hurt her. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Oh, I had her. There she is. I had her hooked on for a little bit. She's getting distracted by the grass. You're getting distracted by the grass, aren't you? Yeah. There's the lead rope. Walk on. There you go. And good. Ho. I'm going to do just one little away from pressure lesson here. Back. Oh, she's leaning. There's a good step. As soon as she took that step back, I released. Let her think about it for a while. Not giving her any kind of praise or reward. Just the release of pressure is her reward. Let's try it again. Another step. Ask for it. Ask for it. Good. Let her think about it. And you would do this from both sides of the horse. Same spot, but a different side. She has to see it from the other side, too. There is that step. Every step she takes, she gets a release. Even after she understands this cue, it's pressure release, step, pressure release. I'm sorry, pressure step release, pressure step release, pressure step release. Let's try the hip. She's leaning into me. Leaning into me. Leaning into me. Good. Sideways step release. Just let her think about it. Just let her think about it. Okay, one more. One more. One more. Come on, you can do it. That's it. Sideways step. Didn't have to be a crossover. Didn't even have to be a complete step. If she would have just shifted her weight, she would have gotten a reward. Okay, walk on. Good girl. See me bump, bump, bump. Not dragging her. Bump, bump, bump. Bump, bump, bump. I broke my sunglasses. I broke my sunglasses. And now that I don't plan to use any kind of a visual reprimand by putting eye contact on her, I go back to wearing my reflective sunglasses. So if I do make inadvertent eye contact, she can't really see it. And it doesn't turn on any alarm bells. And it may look like her ears are pinned right now, but they're not. She's just relaxed and she's paying attention to me because I'm back here behind her vertical. She she's doing fine. Justin, you want me to leave this halter on for the time being? It's on. And she's released. Yeah, she's done for today. We asked a lot of her. You don't want to try to overload her. Sometimes it's hard not to get excited with your success and want to try something else with her. But slow is always faster with a horse. The slower you go, the more you repeat it, the more comfortable they become with the one lesson. You're not wasting any time. And then the time comes to introduce a little bit more, and you can do your hookup after she hooks up solidly, and then do your follow-up exercises by walking away with her, getting her to follow at liberty at your shoulder from both sides, turning into her, making her yield her space. And when she does that without any difficulty, then you can spend another 10 or 15 minutes working on those away-from-pressure lessons on the front, on the shoulder, and on the hip, and then call it a day. Just add little by little. As she starts to get it, you add little by little until she starts to develop a repertoire of things that she fully understands. Now, she's all that chasing we did and getting the adrenaline going, she's not stressed out by that. She wasn't happy with it at the time, but she's not angry with me. If she was, she wouldn't let me come back in and give her a hug. Good girl. Good girl. And that's fine. Yep, she's found the grass. Borrow some poop from another horse and she has to figure out if she knows who the horse is. Okay, let's call it quits. Good girl, Powder.